As I explained in the last episode, Korea used to have a rich wildlife that went all the way to tigers, and together with it, also a rich tradition of cryptids. Basically, the reflection of our human vulnerability facing the big wild nature. If you missed the episode, I recommend you to check it out. Link is in the description or at the corner of the screen. But through the turbulent modern history of a colonial time, brutal civil war, rather messy process of rapid industrialization, the country has lost most of its wildlife, and so its cryptids. The old stories and characters live on in Koreans' imagination and used in various pop cultures, but there have hardly been a new edition, a new story, new witness, or a new encounter. Until, in the late 2000s, several witness accounts of a mystery creature started popping up on internet communities. People pointed out the similarities of these accounts, and soon it was widely accepted that they must be describing the same creature, naming the mystery creature as Jangsan-bum. Jangsan is the name of the mountain in Busan where most of the first accounts were said to have taken place, and bum means a species of a big cat, usually a tiger and occasionally a leopard. Soon various stories and postings followed, the time and setting spanning wider and wider. They were now not confined to just Busan and the surrounding area, but all over Korea, and went to generations back as stories told by posters' grandparents, giving the creature a historic validity too. To sum up the characters of Jangsan-bum, it is a beast about the size and physical proportion of a tiger. It's covered with long white hair, so fine that their strands look almost floating around. Covered in the hair, its facial features are hard to make out except for the glaring blue eyes. It crawls rather than running, more like a sloth on the ground, but it would do that in a lightning speed. When it doesn't move, it can stand or sit more like a human would, and it is often described as having a female vibe to the posture with something sensual and elegant about it. It can mimic various sounds, sometimes even a human voice, and uses it to lure people towards it. And then it seems to hypnotize the victim with its glaring blue lights of eyes. What happens to the victim caught by Jangsan-bum? Nobody seems to know, as all the stories are the accounts of the survivors. The description and stories of Jangsan-bum got so rich and detailed that it took on a life of its own, and it is even made into cartoons and a film. Could Jangsan-bum be true? Or is it at least a cryptid with legend tradition? The general consensus of the scholars of traditional culture and folklore seems to be negative. For a cryptid of such presence and various eyewitness, failing to appear in historic documents and stories should be almost impossible. And yet all of the accounts of Jangsan-bum can be traced only as far back as to the late 2000s. There are a few historic accounts about a big white beast, but they are either one-off or inconsistent to the sad characters of Jangsan-bum. So, Jangsan-bum is most likely a 21st century urban legend that took on the life of its own, fed by the accumulation of people's imagination, as with the case of the Slender Man or the Man in the Dream. It is a bit disappointing to think all the elaborate witness accounts are not true. Nevertheless, it is an interesting case to study how an urban legend can be born, fed into, and become a part of the culture in the internet age. It is also noteworthy how Jangsan-bum fuses the characters of traditional cryptids. The physique of tiger, white hair and female attractiveness of Kumiho, and luring tactics of Changgui. If you don't know what I'm talking about, do watch my previous episode. And finally, I also sense a sort of nostalgia of modern Koreans about the lost nature and wildlife, wanting to believe in the mountains of the land is still something unknown and mysterious that have survived despite of the turbulent modern history of the country. So here are four stories about Jangsan-bum from Korea, whether you believe them to be true or not. As always, handpicked, translated, and narrated by your host, Anthony. This following story is said to be one of the first posting describing what was later to be named Jangsan-bum. Should Jangsan-bum be an urban legend, this should be called the origin story. It's what I experienced about 10 years ago. It may not be so scary, but at least for me, it still is a mystery. I was then a teenager boy and lived near Haeundae in city of Busan. Not far from where I lived was a rather large mountain called Jangsan. I was pretty familiar with the mountain as I had followed my dad several times on hiking. But after this incident, I stopped visiting the mountain. It must have been in early summer. At the crack of dawn on one Sunday, Dad and I were hiking in the mountain. On the trail, suddenly a person in white pushed past me as if he was race walking in the mountain. I didn't fall, but was left stunned. My dad, who was walking ahead of me, said he didn't see what happened. As we carried on the route, I felt something watching me from behind. I turned around and saw a person staring at me from behind a rock in a white fur coat. Fur coat in summertime? Before I could react, the person took a step out from the rock and towards me. I wondered if this wasn't a person who walked past me earlier, but the trail had no crossways or sidewalks, and how could he be now behind me? Suddenly, the person dropped on all fours and started running towards me at an impossible speed. I just clenched my eyes and screamed. When I opened my eyes again, he wasn't there anymore. My dad ran back to me, asking what was wrong. He seemed not having seen what I saw. I don't know if that was a person, or a beast, or a ghost. At first I thought it was wearing a fur coat, but as it dropped down on fours and ran, it did look more like it was its own fur. What was strangest was that I could not make out the details of its face. It looked blurred. I occasionally talked about my experience to my friends and acquaintances too, but none else seems to have seen what I saw in Jangsan. I remember my grandpa used to tell me about what he called a pom. He was adamant that it was something else than a tiger or leopard. He's originally from what is now a part of North Korea, and he'd say he too was told about the pom from his grandfather. I don't remember the details, I was just 4 or 5 when I heard it, but a pom is incredibly strong and fast, but prefers to lure his prey rather than physically hunt it down. It'll either make an indescribable and unlikely noise to trigger people's curiosity, or mimic a cry of a woman. Its glaring blue eyes are so hypnotizing that once one starts looking at them back, one is hooked and cannot run away anymore. Unfortunately, I cannot ask my grandpa for more details anymore because he passed away 13 years ago. Indeed, I would have had a lot more to ask now that I think I saw that pom myself. About 10 years ago, I was in my late teens and had an older girlfriend who lived in Busan. As most native of the port city would, she had had enough of beach and suggested instead to go for a picnic in a mountain. She drove to one, and I, coming from a different town, don't exactly remember which mountain that was. We found ourselves a nice corner at the valley with a stream of water running down. We played in the water a bit and ate lunchbox that my girlfriend had prepared. Then I saw, about the top of the mountain, something white. I saw it but didn't pay much attention until it started moving. I called my girlfriend's attention to it too. She first brushed it off as a cloud or fog, but it didn't take long for her too to realize it wasn't. It had a long body and short legs, like a tiger. It was going up towards the top of the mountain, but the movement could be described as rather crawling than running, as with a tiger or a dog. And an incredible speed too, so much so it felt more like a bird flying up towards the sky. We just kept watching on until it disappeared into the forest. What was that? Had we just seen a ghost or something? But we just shrugged it off. We took a little nap under the shade. I woke up needing to leak, so I walked behind a bush, dragging my sliders. I felt something watching me from behind. The feeling was so vivid, it almost felt physically itchy, and soon turned into a chill running through my body. But pee I had to. And only when I was done, I looked around. Something blue caught my attention. About 20-30 meters from me was a cluster of grass and bushes, and in the dark shadow of them was a couple of icy blue lights, glaring. My instinct started screaming, "That's dangerous! That's dangerous!" But I could not stop looking at the lights nonetheless. I almost felt like getting closer to it to find out what they were. What stopped me was the sound of my girlfriend calling my name. Coming back to myself, I could hear the growling it made. Low growl, as though from a big cat, but with a metallic high pitch to it, almost like that of a woman's scream. With that, I could also slowly make out its furry outline. For a short moment, I wondered if I could chase it away with the screams, but soon realized it was not the usual wildlife that could be scared by such a tactic. I turned around and sprinted back to our picnic ground. When I got close enough to see girlfriend afar, I looked back once to see the blue eye still glaring. I looked one more time when I got to her, and then I could see them no more. All I could mutter to her was, "We should get out of here, right now, right now." I could only relax once we got back to her car. I was still panicking and could not really explain what happened coherently, but my girlfriend just hugged me, trying to convince me that it must have been all but a nightmare. In modern Korea, not from the major city, I can't imagine it could have been a wild predator. Could what my grandpa called a pom then be true? And still alive somewhere in the mountains? Mom says it's what she saw when she was a young girl. Her mom, my grandma, was a devout Buddhist. She ran a bed and breakfast type lodging at the entrance of a famous mountain, popular amongst hikers, and every dawn she went to pray at the temple on the other side of the stream linked by a small stone bridge. My mom has 6 siblings, but she was her mom's favorite. One day, when Mom was about 11 or 12, she for some reason insisted joining Grandma to her morning ritual. So after offering prayers at the temple, Mom was putting her shoes back on when she saw two blue lights flashing on the mountain ridge on the other side. The next second, it flashed again, now further down. At the time, there was not a single street lamp around, and so Mom was holding a hurricane lantern. Grandma told Mom to put the lantern on the ground. Even during that short time, the blue lights were coming ever closer. In the first light of the dawn, Mom could vaguely see that behind the two blue lights were white furry figure. While she wondered what kind of beast he could be, it came further down and closer in a sweeping movement the whole way, never losing the sight of Mom and Grandma. "What's that animal?" To Mom's question, Grandma didn't reply anything, but grabbed a hand and went back into the temple and started reciting Buddhist chants. Mom knew better to make any noise, and all she could hear was her mom's low chanting, but could instinctively sense the beast was now right in the temple yard. Mom fell asleep on the floor despite of herself. When she got up, the sun was up. Under the daylight, what she had seen earlier felt like nothing but a dream. "Was that a white tiger what we saw?" To Mom's naive question, Grandma shot back with such an anger Mom had never seen before, that she should never come along to the temple. Mom asked Grandma about the day when she got older. Grandma's simple answer was that it was a pom. Not the tiger that bites you, but a pom that hypnotizes you. My grandma is 93 this year, but she's still healthy and active, could still easily empty a bottle of soju by herself and sing with a strong voice. Plus, she still remembers things accurately. How she remembers the details of family business from years back surprises me. And she used to tell me this story about Pom when I was a child. And whenever she did, her face grew tense and grave. She would even shiver unlike her usual bold self. When she was in her early 20s, in the late 1930s, she lived in the town now is a part of North Korea. She was already married by then. One day she went up to the nearby mountain with three friends to forage fern shoots. One of them suggested to try somewhere deeper into the forest outside their usual trail, that there should be more ferns. And she was right. There were plenty to forage, fern shoots and many other kind of wild herb and plants. About the midday, the women found a place on a big rock and had their humble lunch of cooked barley, bean paste and cucumber kimchi. Problem was, they didn't bring enough water. Just in time, the weather flipped to dark and heavy and they decided to call it a day. On the way down, one of the women complained how thirsty she was. But still near the rocky top of the mountain, they were nowhere near the stream or spring. Then suddenly they heard a clear sound of water streaming down. The first one insisted that all four of them should seek where the stream was, because she was a bit scared to go by herself. So they followed the direction of the sound, but it seemed they never reached there. While the elusive sound of stream would disappear one moment and then heard again repeatedly. They got all tired and decided rather go back up to the trail. Suddenly, they faced two glaring lights of eyes looking down on them. Its body was covered with fine, long, white fur. It was nothing like tiger or any other wild animal that one could recognize as an animal, no matter how big or scary it is. But this felt more like human, but not human. It gave off the feminine vibe with flowing fine white hair. Under its intense eyes, its mouth was making the noise of the stream that had attracted them down there. The four women dropped everything they had and ran away screaming. So panicked, they could not care how much scratch and bruises they got to roll down through the bushes. They found a little cottage used by professional foragers and herbalists and ran into it, away from the streaming sound that had kept following them. Inside the room was a little statue Buddha, and it stank from the herbs hung to dry all over the wall. They locked the door and huddled together, crying and shivering. The streaming sound stopped. The sound of something sweeping across was heard, and then he called the name of the one who had complained about thirst. So tenderly, so warmly, in the voice of the woman's mother. They dared not breathe hard. Soon, heavy showers started falling, and the woman kept holding on each other. When the shower stopped, it was silent. But none could dare to peep out, and they spent the night in the cottage. When they woke up the next morning, it was still raining, and the woman who had complained about thirst was nowhere to be seen. The rest three could come back to their village, all traumatized and full of scratches. The authority got involved to search for the missing woman, but not a trace was found. My grandma would say in ever so serious voice that she could so clearly remember the glaring eyes and the sound it made, and would insist that Pom and Tiger are not the same creatures. What was it really then? Hi, it's Anthony here, and thank you very much for your listening. This was the fourth and the last episode of the unplanned mini-series on the mysterious stories about animals in Korea. Each episode is interesting for its own right, but I think together they give a bigger picture about Korea, its relationship and tradition to the nature, how we lost them in the modern time, and what has replaced them. Or so I hope, at least. There are still many more stories about Jangsan-bum, by the way. Regardless of their validity, if you want more of those, do let me know in the comments, and I'll select a few more in the future episode. If you haven't yet, please give my video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and share it with others. It will give a little boost to this little channel. Until the next, have a wonderful week, and take care.